We are here this morning to minister to you the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus Christ has given us a commission to go into the world and preach his word. That's why we are here this morning. We are here because it's a mandatory that we should preach the word of God. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Before we start, let us bow down your head and pray. Anywhere you are, this hour, bow down your head and let us pray to God. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Father, we thank you, we bless your holy name.
Amen.
Father, we worship you, we glorify your name. We thank you, Almighty God, for your grace upon our life. We thank you for the gift of life you are giving us. We thank you, Father, because you are a faithful God. We thank you, O King of Glory, who make it possible for us to be alive in the land of the living. Father, we worship you, we glorify your name. We come in this moment unto your hands. Almighty God, we are about to hear your word. The Bible says that the entrance of your word gives light. Precious Father, as your word is coming out this hour, let the power in your word bless your people. Let the power in your word heal your people. Let the power in your word set your people free. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We should understand that the ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ into this world is to set this world free. The coming of our Lord Jesus Christ into this world is not by mistake. Jesus Christ was born into this world for a purpose. Hallelujah. The Bible says in the book of John 8:12, Jesus Christ says, I am the light of the world. He who follows me should not walk into darkness, but walk into light. Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
Yes.
He was born into this world. This world is full of darkness. This world is full of sin. This world is full of corruption. This world is full of iniquities. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus Christ was born into this world to set you free. He is the Savior of the world. Jesus Christ is the Redeemer of the world. He was born to redeem you. He was born to set you free. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says my people perish because of lack of knowledge. Many people are perishing because they are not looking into the light. Many people are perishing because they are living in darkness. I want to let you know that the interest of God in your life is to connect you to the image of Jesus. The interest of God in your life is to connect you to the light, which is Jesus. Your life is very, very important for Jesus. Your soul is very, very important. God does not want you to perish. Jesus does not want you to perish. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are born to shine. You are born to walk in the light. You are not born to walk in darkness. You are not born to condemn. You are born to end your life in heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many people are perishing because they have abandoned Jesus. Many people are perishing because of their sin. We are living in a wicked world full of all kinds of evil, all kinds of wickedness, all kinds of corruption. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And many people are dying one by one. When they die, they end their life in hellfire. The Bible says, my people perish because of lack of knowledge. There are many people of God on this earth. They call themselves a Christian. There are many churches. They call themselves a born again church. There are many prophets and prophetess. They call themselves a Christian. You cannot see any evidence of salvation in their life. They are perishing. You cannot see any evidence of light in their life. They are perishing because they have abandoned God. Many churches have abandoned God. They are worshiping foreign idols. Many people have abandoned Jesus. They are backsliding. Their faith are waxing cold. Many people of God are calling themselves a Christian. They are backsliding. They are abandoned Jesus. They are abandoned God. They are serving foreign gods. Many belong to evil society. Many belong to occultist society. Many belong to witchcraft society. Many are swimming in the ocean of sin. When they die, they found themselves in hellfire. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Remember what happened in the book of Genesis in the days of Noah. They were wrong concerning their sin. They were wrong concerning their wickedness. They rejected the warning of God. They refused to repent. And they perished. They were destroyed with flood. Our land is a consuming fire. We need to fear God. They will perish. How many people were set free in the days of Noah? How many people? Only Noah and his family were set free. Because the whole world perished because of their iniquity. They perished because of their sin. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Remember what happened in the days of Sodom and Gomorrah. The same thing happened. They were living in committing adultery, fornication, lesbian, homosexual, abomination. They are one concerning their sin. They are one concerning all those abomination things they are doing. They rejected the warning of God. They refused to repent. And they will perish. They perish because of their iniquity. They will destroy with fire and brimstone. My brothers and sisters, repent. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent. I want to let you know, without Jesus, no man can see God. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
Without Jesus, no eye can see God. Jesus is the way of your life. He is the way of your salvation. Jesus Christ is the way of your life. Accept Jesus as your Lord, as your personal Savior. Now that you are still living, not tomorrow. Your salvation is free. Come back to Jesus and reconcile with your Maker. Come back to God and reconcile with your Maker. Come back to Jesus and make peace with your Maker. Come back to Almighty God and make peace with God. Make peace with your fellow human being so you can make him at last. The grace of God is upon your life. Now that you are still living, you still have hope to change. You still have hope to come back to Jesus. You still have hope to reject and denounce all those evil things you are doing. You still have hope. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is time for condemnation and there is time for grace. You are living in the hour of grace. The grace of God is upon your life because you are not dead. The Bible says, there is no repentance in the grave. There is no repentance in the grave. Once you die, judgment. But now you are still living. You still have hope to change. You still have hope to reconcile to your Jesus. You still have hope to repent from all those evil things you are doing. I want you to understand, Jesus is coming back again. Avenge your ways. The kingdom of God is at hand. Jesus is coming back again. He is coming back again. Jesus Christ, who was born into this world, who was dying and buried, he is coming back again. Avenge your ways. Hallelujah. He is coming back again to collect the saints. He is coming back again to collect his people. I want you to ask yourself this question. If Jesus Christ comes today, are you going to be among the saints? What is your conscience telling you? If your conscience is condemning you, you need to repent now. You need to accept Jesus so that Jesus will reign in your life. You will no more walk in darkness again. Amen, dear ways. Jesus Christ has promised me and you a better place. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
A better place. He says, in my Father's house, there are many mansions. There are many mansions in heaven. My brothers and sisters, Jesus has promised me and you a better place. We must leave this one day. This one is not our home. We must leave this one day. You have promised us a better place. A mansion is heaven. For you to enter the kingdom of God, you must prepare yourself. Heaven is a prepared place for people that are prepared. You cannot enter heaven anyhow. You cannot go into heaven anyhow. You must prepare yourself. For you to enter the kingdom of God, you must reject and denounce evil. You must reject and denounce all those evil society you belong. You must reject and denounce all those worry attire, all those worry things you are putting on your body. You must repent. For you to enter the kingdom of God, you must repent. You must live a holy and righteous life. Heaven is a place of peace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Heaven is a place of peace. Escape the danger of hellfire. The Bible says in the book of Revelation, if your name are not found in the book of life, you are going to throw into the pit of fire. Many people are joking with fire. Many people are joking with fire. They are pummeling their sin. They are committing their errors. They are joking with fire. Our Lord is a consuming fire. Hallelujah. He is also a visible fire. A visible father. Escape the danger of hellfire so that you will not perish. Where are you going to spend your eternity? My brother and sister, ask yourself this question. Where are you going to spend your eternity? Where are you going to spend your life? Very soon, rapture will take place. Once there is rapture, there is no more grace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Very soon, rapture will take place. Once there is rapture, there is no more grace. We are running our final race. Everything you are doing on this earth is your final race. All the evil things you are doing, all the good things you are doing on this earth, it is your final race. How are you going to end your life? Ask yourself this question. If your conscience is condemning you, you need to repent. How are you going to end your life? You need to live as a sinner. How are you going to end your life? It doesn't matter how you start your race. It doesn't matter how you start your life. You may start your life as a sinner. You may start your life as a saint. But in conclusion, how are you going to end that life? Hallelujah. Without Jesus, you cannot enter the kingdom of God. Escape the danger of hellfire. Repent and reject all those things you are doing. I want to let you know, life does not end on this world. After death, anywhere you find yourself after death is the place you are going to spend the rest of your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Keep that one in mind. Life does not end on this world. After death, any place you find yourself is where you are going to spend your eternity. Some people will find themselves in hellfire. Some will find themselves in hell. What is their conscience telling you? Are you sure you are going to make it to the end? Are you sure you are going to inherit the kingdom of God? You still have grace to change. You still have grace to amend your ways. God so loved the world, He gave the only begotten Son, Jesus. Whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God loves you, even you as a sinner. God loves you because even you as a sinner, but God has said. God loves you. Jesus Christ died for the whole world. He died for all the sinners. I want to let you know, the death of Jesus on the cross of Calvary is not in vain. His death is not in vain. He died so that you should not perish. He died so that you end your life in heaven. My brothers and sisters, I want to let you know, the blood of Jesus is waiting to wash away your sin. Only if you can ask the mercy of God today and repent from all your sin. That precious blood that poured on the cross of Calvary is waiting to sanctify you. That blood is waiting to purify you. That blood is waiting to cleanse you. Only if you confess your sin. Only if you can repent and reject all those things you are doing. Only if you can come back to Jesus and amend your ways. That precious blood is waiting to sanctify you. That blood is waiting to purify you. That blood is waiting to cleanse you. That blood will make you whole. Repent! The kingdom of God is at hand. Jesus is coming back again. My brothers and sisters, Jesus is coming. Jesus Christ, who was born into this world, who was dying and buried, He is coming back again. He is coming back again. The coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, He will be like this coronavirus. Coronavirus just enter without any sign. And people are crying. And people are running. And people are running helter skelter. That is how it's going to be. The day Jesus Christ will come. It will come like a thief. Many people will cry. Many people will say, "Hey, I know. Hey, I know cannot set you free. Hey, I know cannot set you free." Now is the hour for you to repent. The grace of God is upon your life this hour. You still have grace to repent. You still have grace to come back to Jesus. Amend your ways. The kingdom of God is at hand. My brothers and sisters, as you have heard this word this hour, be the hearer and the doer of the word, so that it shall be well with you. If you are living as a sinner, today, repent from all your sin. Come back to Jesus. Walk in the light of God. Today is the day of your salvation. Your salvation is free. God is calling you. Jesus is calling you. Amend your ways and live a holy and righteous life. I pray that the grace of God will be upon your life for you to live a holy and righteous life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray that the grace that will make you to live a holy and righteous life, that the grace that will make you to end your life in heaven be raised upon your life now. Receive that grace. I say receive it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I wish each one of us heaven at last in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are all blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Finally, Jesus said, sin no more. My brothers and sisters, sin no more. Your salvation is permanent. Your repentance is permanent. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen. What shall it profit you if you gain all this world? If you gain all this world, what shall it profit you if you gain all this world and lose your soul? Hallelujah. What shall it profit you if you gain all this world? If you gain all this world, what shall it profit you if you gain all this world? Hallelujah, hallelujah.
What
shall it profit you if you gain all this world? If you gain all this world, what shall it profit you if you gain all this world and lose your soul? On the last day, on the last day, only true believers shall be raptured.
On the last day, only true believers shall be raptured.
on the last day, only two believers shall be raptured.
On the last day,
only two believers shall be raptured. Oh, on the last day, only two believers shall be raptured.
On the last day,
on the last day, only two believers shall be raptured. Tell me the hope you have, my brother. Kingdom of God is the hope I have. The kingdom. I say, tell me the hope you have, my sister.
Kingdom of God, the hope I have. Kingdom of God.
I say, tell me the hope you have, my brother. Kingdom of God is the hope I have. The kingdom. I say, tell me the hope you have, my sister.
Kingdom of God
is the hope I have. The kingdom of God is the hope I have. The kingdom of God. Continue. Jesus said, continue. I am coming very soon. By and by. By and by. Continue. Jesus said, continue. I am coming very soon. By and by. By and by.
Continue.
Jesus said, continue. I am coming very soon. By and by and by, continue. Jesus said, continue. I am coming very soon. By and by, Jesus said, continue. I am coming very soon. By and by, Jesus said, continue. I am coming very soon. By and by, Jesus said, continue. I am coming very soon. By and by, continue. Jesus said, continue. I am coming very soon. By and by, Jesus said, continue. I am coming very soon. By and by, continue. Jesus said, continue. I am coming very soon, by and by. You are the Lamb of God that take away sorrow. You are the Lamb of God that take away, oh, take away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God that take away
sorrow. You are the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
You take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
You take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
You take away sorrow.
Jesus,
the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
You take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God that take
away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God that take away sorrow. Jesus, the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God that take
away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
Take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
Jesus, take away sorrow.
Jesus,
the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
Take away sorrow. You are the
Lamb of God that take away problem.
Jesus, the Lamb of God that
take away sorrow. Take away problem.
You are the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
Take away sorrow.
Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
Take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
Take away sorrow.
You Lamb of God that take away sorrow.
Take away affliction.
You are the
Lamb of God that take away sorrow. Take away sorrow. Take
away
Jesus, take away problems.
Jesus, the
Lamb of God, I take away. Take away problems.
Jesus, the Lamb of God,
I take away. Take away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God, take away sorrow.
Take away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God,
I take away. Take away affliction.
Jesus, the Lamb of God,
I take away sorrow.
Take away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God, I take away.
Take away problems.
Jesus,
the Lamb of God,
I take away.
Take away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God,
I take away.
Take away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God, I take away sorrow.
Take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God, I take away sorrow.
Take away problems.
Jesus, the Lamb of God, you are the Lamb of God.
Take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God, I take away sorrow.
Take away sorrow.
Jesus, you are Lamb of God, I take away sorrow.
Take away sorrow.
Jesus, the Lamb of God, I take away sorrow.
Take away sorrow.
You are the Lamb of God, I
take away sorrow. I want to to know you more. I want to know you more and more. I want to know you more. I want to know you every day, Jesus.
I want to know the more.
I want to know you more and more. I want to know you more. I want to know you every day. I want to know you more. I want to know you every day. I want to know you more. I want to know you every day, Jesus. I want to know you, my Jesus. I want to know you, my. I want to know you every day. I want to know you, my. I want to know you every day. I want to know you, my. I want to know you every day, Jesus.
You my, I want to know you, my Jesus.
I want to know you, my. I want to know you every day. I want to know you, my. I want to know you every day. I want to know you, my. I want to know you every day, Jesus.
You more, I want to know you more, Jesus. I want to know you.
I want to know you every day. He that cometh from above, he that cometh from above is above them all. He that cometh from above,
he that cometh from above is above them all.
He that cometh from above, he that cometh from above is above them all. He that cometh from above,
he that cometh above is above them all.
Jesus cometh from above, he that cometh from above is above them all. He that cometh from above,
he that cometh above is above them all.
He that cometh from above, he that cometh from above is above them all. He that cometh from above,
he that cometh above
is above them all. He that cometh from above, he that cometh from above is above them all. He that cometh from above,
he that cometh from above
is above them all. Jesus cometh from above, he that cometh from above is above them all. Holy Ghost cometh from above,
he that cometh from above
is above them all.
He that cometh from above
is above them all. He that cometh from above,
he that cometh from above is above them all.
He that cometh from above,
he that cometh from above
is above them all. He that cometh from above,
he that cometh from above is above them all.
He that cometh from above,
he that cometh from above is above them all.
He that cometh from above,
he that cometh from above is above them all.
He that cometh from above,
he that cometh from above is above them all.
He that cometh from above,
he that cometh from above is above them all.
He that cometh from above,
he that cometh from above is above them all.
He that cometh from above,
he that cometh from above is above them all.
I'm standing on the word of God, the word of God is power. I'm standing on the word of God,
the word of God is power.
I'm standing on the word of God,
the word of God is power.
I'm standing on the word of God,
the word of God is power.
We are standing on the word of God,
the word of God is power.
Power in the word of God. 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 Power in Power in the word of God. 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 Come down, power. Power, come down, power. Power, come down, power. Come down, power. Come down, power. Power, come down, power.
Minus that, no eye shall see God.
Jesus is calling us to repent. We should stop lying. We should stop stealing. We should stop killing. We should stop asking and receiving bribe. Nigeria, Jesus is telling you to stop receiving bribe. Nigeria, Jesus is telling you to stop asking for bribe. Every small thing they're asking for bribe. Bribery is against the word of God. It is a sin. It will lead you to hell if you don't repent. Repent and stop asking for bribe. Repent and stop giving bribe, Nigeria. Nigeria is full of bribery, and Jesus is calling you to repent. Repent from every non-sin. Repent, repent, repent. Every sin is sin. There is no big sin and there is no small sin. Even the one you think is small can land you in hell if you don't repent. Repent and start living a holy and righteous life. Repent from every non-sin. Stop fornicating. Stop cheating on your husband. Stop cheating on your wife. Stop sleeping with prostitutes. You should repent. If you're a prostitute, Jesus is telling you to repent. If you're a married woman sleeping around, Jesus is telling you to repent. If you are a married man sleeping around, Jesus is telling you to repent. If you have more than one wife, you have to do restitution and return those extra wives to their family house. God made one man for one woman, one woman for one man. If your husband have married before, you should go back to your father's house. You should go back. One wife for one man for one wife. That is it. There should be no second wife. There should be no third wife. There should be no fourth wife. There should be no sixth wife. One wife, one man. One husband, one wife. Nigeria, God is calling us to repent. The world is turning around. This world is not coming back like before. This world is not coming back like normal again. We are heading down, down. The world is coming to an end. We have the grace now to repent. We have the grace now to repent. God gave us this grace to repent. The grace is not to sin. The grace that was given to us is for what? To repent and start living a holy and righteous life. Some of you say, by the grace of God, everybody shall make heaven. Why did God create heaven and hell? You see, God is a merciful father, and he's also what? A consuming fire. If you don't repent and die in your sin, you are ending up in hell. We have only heaven and hell, no purgatory. So if you die, you cannot go to purgatory. You are going to either heaven or hell. You choose where to go. You choose whether to go to heaven or whether to go to hell and start working on that side. If you find yourself in hell, you shall blame yourself and not God. We are given right to do right or evil. If you choose to do evil, if you refuse to repent and you end up in hell, you should blame yourself. There is no second rapture. If rapture come right now, where are you going to be? After rapture, there will not be second rapture. Only one rapture. Only one rapture. Work for your salvation. Some people will die before rapture. Some people will not be alive during the time of rapture, which means you have to repent now. You have to live a right and righteous life, because whenever you die, that is your own rapture. You can rapture to hell or you can rapture to heaven, because the Bible says that after death is what? After death is what?
Judgment.
Judgment comes after death. So when you die, you'll be judged. You will be judged according to your evil way. You'll be judged according to your good way. Repent. Teach your children the ways of God. Right now that they are small, teach your children the ways of God. Start teaching your children when they are small. Not when they are big, you cannot teach them anymore. Teach your children. When you are going to church, go with your children. Go with your husband. Go with your wife. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Go with your wife to church. Go with your husband to church. Go with your children. Teach them the word of God. Preach to them. Preach to them. Tell them to avoid sins, because all sin is sin. Tell them to avoid sins and start living a right and righteous life. Nigeria, there is nothing like women trouser. There is nothing like women trouser. All trouser belongs to men. If you are still wearing trouser, you better give it to the men. There is nothing like women trouser in the Bible. We were told in the Bible, men should not wear women clothing, and women should not wear men clothing. Women, why are you still wearing trouser? Is trouser women outfit? Trouser is not meant for women, it's meant for men. Trouser is for a man, not for a woman. You should remove your trouser and give it to a man, because that is for them. Trouser is not for women.
Women, you should stop bleaching your skin. God created us according to his own image and likeness. You should stop bleaching your skin and appreciate your life. You should stop bleaching your skin and appreciate the way God made you. God made us according to his own likeness, which means we resemble God. Why are you bleaching your skin? Why are you destroying your skin? Some that are bleached their skin, you won't even know if they are black or white, because they will have taken over. You bleach your skin, you destroy your skin. When you die under that condition, you are not going to heaven, because God gave you a black skin. So white people are turning their skin to look black. So white people are turning their skin, and the black people are bleaching their skin. All this makeup you are putting on your body, where are you born with makeup? Where are you born with makeup? Where are you born with jewelry? All this earring you are wearing, where are you born with it? Look at my ears. I have 6 holes over here on my ear. 6 holes, because I didn't know what I was doing. I have tattooed over here. I got 15 years ago. I have tattooed over here, but it's an abomination. If you have tattoo, ask God for mercy and forgiveness and sin no more. Tattoo is an abomination. When you go to Leviticus, it is over there. Tattoo is an abomination. 19:28. It says, do not put any mark or any cut in your body. You see all the mark. I have 6 marks over here. It is an abomination. Ask God for mercy and forgiveness. Women, stop putting a hole in your children's ears, your daughter's ear. Stop piercing their ear. It is against the word of God in the Bible. The Bible tells us that we shall not pierce our ears. We shall not pierce our body. We shall not do tattoo. But look at my tattoo over again. Look at my tattoo here. I have already asked God for mercy and forgiveness. Do this time and see no more. Go and see no more. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He is able. Abundant able to deliver and to heal. Jesus is able, abundantly able to deliver who trusts in him. He is able, abundantly able to deliver and to heal. Jesus is able, abundantly able to deliver, oh, trust in him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
As many who has heard us this morning, you have heard many preachers preaching, and you are ready to repent and surrender your life to Jesus. We want to pray with you, and we want to also pray for the people, for the sellers and for the buyers, those who have come to the market, those who have given us this audience to preach, those who has respected the word of God. We want also to commit your lives into the hands of God, and whatever you do for living and the righteous thing you do for living, we also want to commit it into the hands of God, that God will lift you up and prosper you in every areas of your life and every endeavor. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this opportunity given to us to preach your word. We also thank you for the opportunity given to as many that has heard us this morning because of these mercies and the grace. We praise you and we worship you. And we pray that the word that has sown into their hands, the word that has sown into their hearts, will germinate and bear fruits in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We plead the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Father, we plead the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
We pray, Lord, that whatever you have started, the Bible says you will perfect it. We pray that you perfect your words and perfect your ways this morning in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As many who are here and they are coming to buy and coming to sell, all the sellers in the market, Lord, we commit them into their hands. Whatever be their needs, we pray, oh Lord, that you meet them according to their needs in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Prosper them in their ways.
Amen.
As they display their ways, Lord, bring customers from left and right and prosper them in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And from henceforth, let there be no lack in their midst.
Amen.
Lord, make their ways to be straight.
Amen.
Have your way. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. You are blessed.